Greetings, travelers, and welcome to episode 35 of WesterosCraft Walks with your loving host, Dutch Guard. In today's episode, we will be exploring Silverhill, the seat of House Serret in the Westerlands. In fact, we are on the southernmost border of the Westerlands, bordering with the Reach, which is just down the river here. This river, in fact, flows past Golden Grove and meets with the Mander and heads out to the Sunset Sea past Highgarden. So this is a pretty important trading port for the Westerlanders, it's pretty much one of their main routes into the Reach from here. And it's probably also their first line of defense from the Reach in case they ever decide to sail up the river and cause them some trouble. You can also see behind me here we've got some of the beautiful mountains of the Westerlands, since we are in one of the hillier and more mountainous regions of the Westerlands, just forming part of that mountain range which divides Lannisport with the Riverlands. And here we've got this little port town, which is just a part of Silverhill, and we'll travel the road along and find the castle. But first, let's start in this town here. We've got some lovely, looks like inns, some warehouses. We've got some fishing netting hanging about, a little fisherman's stall, which I think is quite cool. This must be a blacksmith, the Battered Anvil Inn and Tavern. Oh, it's an inn! Maybe it's a smithy and an inn. We've got a nice little eating area here, probably some kitchens and some rooms upstairs. I do love these little plates of food textures that we have, just adds that extra level of detail. So we've got some ships out on the river here, which are quite cool. I really just love these mountains. The terrain is just fantastic, at least in the Westerlands here. Of course, we've got the Vale as well, but the Westerlands mountains are also pretty formidable. So we've got some smaller houses here with the typical Westerland sort of brick and wattle blocks. We've got some dub and wattle there as well, and the thatch roof textures, which are always a standard. We've got some sort of house that sells eggs or something. Maybe there's a chicken coop around back. Let's see if we can find, well, up here must be sort of the sleeping quarters. Yeah, you can see sort of that beaten up beds up there for some of the poorer people. Oh yeah, they must have some chicken coops around here. Now I'm curious. I'm going to find those chicken coops. They must be in the back around here somewhere. Yes, just out the side here, looks like. Probably have some chickens running around. In fact, they probably ran wild around the town here, and they just wrangle them up whenever they lay eggs. That's just sort of part of the atmosphere of the medieval town that we're trying to create. So that's pretty much that little town there. It's got some cool builds, some cool little features as well. We've got another little set of houses up here, which I believe could be a sort of an inn or a wealthier merchant, or I'm not sure actually. Let's see what the sign says. It says, that's the way to Silverhall Castle. But here, it just looks like another collection of buildings, sort of the more upper class, away from the dock area. So we've got a baker here, a bakery, which I think is quite cool. We've got the cakes and breads. Let's take a look inside. Right, we've got some ovens here, a big hearth. I see. This is sort of an outdoor bakery type thing. Very sort of a modern invention, I think, but perhaps that gives the bread a unique flavor. The flavors of the Mander coming off the river there. what else have we got? We got, looks like perhaps a greengrocer's with all kinds of different fruits and vegetables. Very cool. We got some melons as well. Very important. I don't know if they actually have melons in Westeros. We do generally try and stick to the sort of vegetation mentioned in A Song of Ice and Fire, and not go above and beyond that. Oh, cool, we've got some notes hanging up here, some public notices, perhaps, as well as some other houses here as well. Up on the hill there, we've got a really interesting kind of sept. I know that's based on some concept art. If you look up some sept concept art, there's one that looks a bit like that. We don't have time to look at that today, but if you slash warp Silverhill, you can check it out yourself. Here we've got some other up-class residencies. Looks like a little chandelier hanging from the ceiling. I quite like that design. We've got some carpet on the floor, so yeah, this looks like probably an upper middle class residence, perhaps. Actually, probably upper class. You know, now that they say it's a pretty sizable house. It's got glass windows, all the different materials, and it's a nice wooden roof. At least upper class for Silverhill area. And of course, every region wouldn't be complete without some farmland. So we've got some, looks like some peas here and some wheat, as well as some unused fields in the back there for now, being fertilized or recycled or put in the cycle of farming or whatever it is. So one of those houses back there must have been a farmer's house. And I think we've got like a little shed here with some hay and grain for our horses perhaps, or just for storage for the time being. So we're just walking along this road here to the castle. We've got some lovely trees to our left and right. It's not as dense as a forest, but I like the sort of sparsely planted trees in this area. Alright, we've got a little encampment here, perhaps from a hedge knight. It's a pretty sizable tent in here. Yeah, it looks like a hedge knight. We've got some shields here, some thatch beds, some chests, perhaps for armor. Of course, we've got some laundry hanging out to dry. Perhaps it rained recently. And moving right along, Silverhill must be showing up in the distance very shortly. Of course, if you keep following this road, you'll head deeper and deeper into the Westerlands, and the roads will eventually lead you to Lannisport, as all the roads are connected, at least in some of our more complete regions, Westerlands being one of them. Well, that's also a mine that way, don't have time for that one today, but there we go, we can see Silverhill just rendering in the distance there, and we can sort of see the flag of the Serrets hanging above the gate there, the peacock on cream. I know that Brienne runs into a Serret at one point or another, but I won't say where or when. She does do that. I was just looking at the wiki, really, and I was like, oh, there's really not much on House Serret. Yeah, there's that bit. But they have a really cool castle, actually. I do love the sort of style. This is the Westlands, but as it sort of is closer to the Reach, the builder sort of stuck to the more stony, Riverlands-y kind of palette. We've also got a nice statue of a peacock over there, which I think is quite cool. Every once in a while, you'll see a statue of the sigil or of the house animal out in the yard or out in front of the gates or something. Sort of like with Lannisport and the big lions. Okay, so here we are in the outer yard of Silverhill. We've got some stables in here. We've got a big granary on my left here, which I think is quite a cool design. The stairs over there just lead up to the top for emptying the grain out into that granary. We've got some more storage in here. Of course, storage is a huge deal just for stocking up for the winter and stuff, especially in Westeros where those winters can be very, very long. We've got a nice little well in there, which is quite cool. And then just going around, I think I'm just going to go into the main hall, which I think is just through here. See some more of the colors of House Serret there. Yeah, so that would be the main hall. You can see a flag of the Lannisters as well, of course. They're the ruling house of the Westerlands, so House Serret is sworn to them. And just heading along here, up these stairs, I think I'm going to try and find the Godswood. Here we are. So this little Godswood, again, there's no weirwood or anything because we are sort of below the God's Eye, but it is a really, really nice little Godswood. I love the sort of overgrown feel of it with all the vines growing up these trunks here. I think that's a pretty cool detail to add. Sometimes we go a little crazy with the vines, but I think everything in moderation, it tends to look pretty good. So let's work our way around the castle. I haven't really done too much exploration through here, but let's see what we can find. We've got some barracks through here, just guessing by the helmet. We've got washing up area over here with a little garden in the back, which is quite cool. I do love the sort of walls. Cool, there's a stair right up to the wall. So over here there's a massive drop, but on this side it's sort of like the land has been built up, which is quite cool. I sort of love that, and you get this looking out into the outer yard where we came in. Alright, so let's head around the walls, actually, see if we can find our way to that main tower. I do love all these little wall turrets as well and towers, especially sort of this Norman style of square tower. I just think it's, you know, classical, and it's not too fantasy and realistic, and really it's sort of the best design short of circular towers, which are just a little sturdier. Where am I going? I think if I just keep heading up these stairs, I'll find something. I know what I'm looking for. Never mind. We've got some trapdoors leading us up here. Oh, I'm just going to cheat and go up here. we've got a bell tower up here with a really cool looking copper or bronze bell, sort of an oxidized bronze there, which is quite cool. We've got some, this looks like flags that have been rolled up that can perhaps fly from the top of this tower. Let's see if we can find our way down through this tower. Oh god, I hope there's a ladder or something. There we go. We've got, I just love sometimes when we include bells. They're good just for warning the villagers in case they're under attack so they can seek refuge in the castle. And yes, we found the rookery. It's kind of a small one, but I like that this one has a map of Westeros, so the maester sort of knows where to send his ravens. We've got the cages here for the different ravens, some grain, no meat in this one, perhaps they're vegetarian ravens in this tower. And here we've got sort of the maester's chambers, which are quite nice. You can sort of the black, colorless sheets and bedding of the maester. They tend to, of course, give up their house titles and names and sigils, so they sort of stick to basic black and gray and white or whatever. The stairs. Now we gotta find the stairs to go down. Where could it be? Oh, cool. This is like a little gate to release the ravens out into the Godswood. Pretty cool. Perhaps the ravens actually kind of live in the Godswood. That would be pretty cool, wouldn't it? Let's see. Stairs. God, they've got to be around here somewhere. I reckon they're hiding around the corner here. Nope. I think these may... Oh, wait! There we go. Some of these castles can be just a little bit confusing. We've got the maester's quarters down here, sort of there. Oh, man, there we've got the autopsy bench there. We've got a nice little library, some sour leaf leaves there. I do love that we just added that texture, sour leaf, of course, which is sort of the red cabbage that famously the innkeep, the crossroads, chews on. All right, just heading out into the walls again. You can see this beautiful godswood on the left here, which is quite cool. I just love all the trees growing out and over the castle. Let's see if we can find our way all the way to the top there. It must be the Lord Solar, or perhaps the Royal Chambers up there. So let's see if we can get our way up there. Yeah, I think I need to get through here. So let's get to the top of this little defensive tower here. See if we can find our way through. So yeah, I do love getting lost in these castles. I mean, sometimes it's the best way to get immersed, really. Oh no, damn! It's a dead end. Okay, jump down. Whee! Let's see if we can find our way through the yard, perhaps. Oh, so we found our way into an inner yard, and you can see sort of like a little melee practicing arena here with some dummies there for practicing. And looks like we've got maybe a smith through here, some archery targets over here, which are quite cool. Right, I need to get my way into the main hall again. Of course, these castles are defensively built, so you've got all these like in-between portcullises, which are quite cool. And these main gates, and you do sort of want to have the least number of entrances possible in order to invade and enter the main keep, where all, of course, the most important family members reside. Yes, stairs going up, 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 and through this door, and oh, cool, we've got some chambers here. Looks like perhaps a Lannister is staying here because of the Lannister colors there. Or a Lannister from Lannisport. and we've got a Serret living in here based on the colors there of the canopy. Nice little balcony view over the Godswood. I do love little touches like that. Full of love today. Loving so many of the little details here at Silverhill. For such a small build, this is actually getting to be quite a long video, but you know what, guys? I took a break for too long, and you deserve it. You really do. So I'm going to spend as much time as I can on these builds, because there's always so much to see and never enough time to see it in. We've got the Scepter Chloe living in here, which is quite cool. Some of these rooms will be named, of course. Scepter Chloe can probably read and write, so we can forgive her that she's written a sign above her door. We've got a nice little portrait of the mother there. Of course, very important to Scepters, as they are sort of motherly figures. And perhaps we've got some servants living in this room here. A little less literate, perhaps. right, let's see if we can find our way further up. I'm looking for some stairs. There we go. We've got some nice wide stairs here, of course, for the lords, just in case they have difficulty going upstairs. You never know. We have fat lords as well, and crippled lords. that's probably why Castle Rock is so cripple-friendly, or at least for Tyrion anyway, because it's got loads of lifts and things for carrying people up and down. Okay, great. So this must be the Lord Solar all the way at the top. And we've got sort of a writing desk here and a little bench for guests. A nice floor-length mirror. Very lavishly furnished, I must say. Cool, you can see sort of the top of the tower and a nice little chandelier. And the sigil of the Lannisters, of course, and the house the Serrets are sworn to. Right, so here we are on this little balcony, which I think is quite nice. And that's the road. Must be heading back out to the town. See if we can see it in the distance there. I don't know. Might just be able to see that hedge knight encampment in the distance. But otherwise, around us in all directions, we've got lots of forest, and you can see why this castle was built up here on this hill, and which is why it's called Silver Hill. It's just a really cool defensive vantage point, and just a really cool scenic location. So, many thanks for watching, guys. That was Silver Hill, and I will see you next time for episode 36.